Just off Martinique's southern coast, Diamond Rock, a volcanic plug made of basalt, named for its jewel-like shape. In the early 1800s, the British used Diamond Rock as an armed fort during the Napoleonic Wars. Today, it's a famed diving site. Nearby, a stirring memorial sculpted by Laurent Vallaire.
I discovered these stories, these facts, in history books. I tell myself it's not possible. We have to do something here.
In 1830, a slave ship from West Africa, perhaps Nigeria or Benin, crashed here at Ants Kafar.
It was about 11 p.m. and they discovered people on the rocks. A lot of people died. They came here together with their families, father, mother, kids.
Vallaire's 1998 memorial commemorates the 150th anniversary of the abolition of slavery in Martinique. Facing West Africa, these 15 figures are made of fiberglass and concrete.
I made it in concrete with a triangular form to symbolize triangular trade, which was a business from Europe to Africa to America.
This expanse, once used for soccer, is now one of the most visited places on the island.
I am very happy, very proud. And the most important is to share this history, because it's not only a matter of history, it's a question of human rights, especially in these times.
History meets the present day wherever one travels in Martinique, an island that takes pride in its diversity of people, culture, and natural wonders.
To work on this island, it's like a paradise. When the people come on Martinique, we have a very large desire to show them what we can offer.
Just gorgeous, and that sculpture on the cliff is so powerful and a big draw for visitors. In addition to the memorial, there is an underwater sculpture park offshore. Martinique is a very special place, and it really does have something for everyone. And that is Chronicle for tonight. Thanks so much for joining us. I'm Shayna Seymour. We hope to see you back here on Monday night. Have a good one, everyone.